a Gotham cop doing their job? That'd be the day.
I mean.
No, you're right. Renee's an anomaly, which is why we need her on our side.
Facts. Anyways, what is good, guys? It is your boy, Jason JV, saying welcome to another Gotham Knights video. And yes, yes, y'all, been messing around with some suit mods. As you can see, we got a modded Nightwing suit here. We also have a modded Red Robin, suit for Tim Drake. And then we have a modded Batgirl suit, oh yeah, for Babs. And then we have another modded suit for Jason Todd. I'll show you guys my modded suit collection, you know, once I finish the game, because I'm pretty sure I'm going to have more in my inventory. But anyway, we're playing as Dick right now. We're not going to use him in any, like, story missions or anything like that. I just selected him because apparently he has a cutscene, so we're going to go ahead and get into this. Why you getting an ice pack? You didn't do much.
More than anyone, that being a leader has a cost. You needn't shoulder it all alone.
I don't know what you're talking about.
You know, at times, you can be much like Bruce.
Nothing like you.
So unlike him, you would never push through an injury.
I'm fine. See?
Yeah, you're not fine.
I'm good.
No, you're not.
Knowing when to take the help that's offered is a sign of a good leader.
Don't be too proud. Alrighty. I wonder if, full tiny Dim has a cutscene. We'll see. Let's change characters. Oh yeah, he does.
Raiding Star Labs was a brash move, even for Freeze. We need to expect the worst from him.
Little bonding experience here.
Hand me that coolant.
Did it hurt, Jason?
When I fell from heaven?
Came back to life. Did the Lazarus pit hurt?
It changed me.
doesn't want us to try.
Supposed to do. Try grieving.
Foreshadowing there much? I wonder if I ever unlocked any colorways for the Bat Bike. No, not yet. Whoops. Nah, I like that bike. That bike's classic looking. Alright, let's see if Babs has a cutscene. She has nothing yet?
Master Richard.
Alright, we'll go back to Jason then.
Could you keep an eye on Master? He's been quite upset since the events at Star Labs.
I'm right here.
Freeze getting away was a hard pill to swallow. I'll make sure he's okay.
Thank you. The Court of Owls is watching from inside of Gotham's walls. They lurk in every shadow, and they rule us one and all.
I always figured that rhyme was just to scare kids into being good, like Gotham's version of Santa Claus.
When Bruce began investigating the court, he wondered if even he was being too cautious, chasing a fairy tale. It seems impossible that someone could control Gotham from the shadows without Batman finding out.
The court must be hella powerful to hide like this for so long. For all we know, anyone could be in on it.
A grand conspiracy. I'm not sure Bruce would be gratified to find his suspicions were right.
Alrighty, so what are we supposed to do?
Unfortunately, the regulators managed to escape with a lot of confidence.
Let's check our emails. Oswald Cobblepot. Oswald, don't know if you kids have access to this, but I have no clue how else to contact you. Not sure if he told you this, but the big guy and I had a deal. One that benefited us both. If you're interested in keeping it going, come see me at the lounge. Meet me on the roof. I don't want to risk you breaking my door again. Jada Tompkins. Organ thefts. Hey Batman, this is Jada. My mom gave me this address in case I needed to contact you. There's been a big spike in organ theft lately. And the GCPD aren't doing anything about it. I know you're busy, but I don't know who else to turn to. If you can recover any stolen organs, get them to my mobile clinic, and I'll be sure they're sent to the right people. Alrighty. Lucius Fox, your friend in the Belfry told me your team managed to get the place back up and running again. The 3D printer Batman had me install may have accumulated some dust in the last few years, but I'm sure it can still fulfill all of your needs. We came up with some pretty innovative designs back then, so I'm excited to see what you'll make with it. While you work on crafting new equipment, I'm developing some interesting prototypes for you. I'm looking forward to sharing when the time is right. Okay. Unsurprisingly, Langstrom wasn't working alone. He had an assistant helping him with his, let's say, less savory work. I suspect he knew about the court too. I wonder if he was a plant. File attached. See, Master Todd, I couldn't help but notice that you've been going on longer and more frequent patrols of late, and I just want to ensure you are not burning yourself out. One cannot outrun their grief, nor can one beat it into submission. Make sure you are taking time you need it all. And there he be. Look who's all dressed to the nines.
Welcome back. Had a good time rubbing elbows with the beautiful people.
They're not my type. So, what did you want to talk about?
Straight to the point. I like that about you. So, how's about a little partnership?
Thanks. I always thought about how I'd run this place. To start, I'm gonna need this office for myself.
You misunderstand me, friend. As the owner of a respected establishment, I have an interest in keeping the streets safe. You could help.
You mean take out competition?
I'm not in the crime business anymore. So if I came across any unusual gear, I'd be obliged to turn it over. Upstanding citizen that I am.
I'm only doing this because I'm already going after those criminals.
Well, that's the spirit.
Who have we here? So Alfred tells me you've been working hard on your bat gadgets.
Well, they're more like red gadgets. Like bat gadgets, but with an extra kick.
But you know you're going to run into supply issues eventually, right?
Yeah, I could tell you I'd planned for that, but then I'd be lying.
Tell you what, you keep busy with your superhero business, and I'll keep you supplied with components. You good with that?
Whatever you say, Fox.
Yes, sir.
Hey, Hero. Over here. So, where's Batman? He owes me a coffee.
He's unavailable.
Well, Dad, sorry. He really helped Mum and I out a lot.
How's Leslie been anyway?
She's fine, enjoying retirement, watches medical dramas to nitpick them. But there's still a shit ton of work to do here, for both of us.
Yeah, it never ends, does it?
You've been helping people in Gotham, and that's great. So keep it up. Come visit me once in a while, and I'll pass on anything helpful I might find. Besides, Mom will send both of us to the ER if I don't keep an eye on your health.
How could I say no?
About time you showed up.
Call me Red Hood. And your name is?
If I don't need to know your real name, you don't need to know mine. I got grandkids to think about.
Fair.
You can just call me Madame Palomares.
Okay, Madame Palomares. Got your message. Said you had some intel for me.
I do. What I'm about to tell you is highly confidential. There's a group of us. People who want to see real change in Gotham. We call ourselves the Watch.
Impressive.
I started the group years ago and I got fed up with all the bad apples in this town.
Been there.
I reached out to Batman for help. He wasn't too sure about us at first, but I showed him that having eyes on the ground could be useful. So we started giving him tips to help him keep our neighborhood safe. He told me that if he ever went quiet for this long, that I should reach out to you.
He was right. I'll do whatever I can to keep your neighborhood safe, ma'am.
I'll spread the word to the other members of the Watch. He is missed. But the entire Watch has your back. We can do this. Together.
Sure.
Belfry, everything looks normal. for that door.
It would probably be well hidden. Remember the court rhyme? The Court of Owls is watching.
From inside Gotham's walls. I know.
So... found it.
Hello. Something else, Scout Cookies. I'm in, Belfry.
What are you saying? Who's selling Girl Scout cookies? Brett. Now, what am I looking for? Scan the document. What document?
Moreno. I know that name from somewhere. Belfry, do you remember a murder case? Victim was someone named Moreno.
Of course. The brother of Elena Moreno, a local judge. She took a leave of absence from the bench directly afterward for family reasons.
It looks like the Court of Owls ordered the hit. Let me see what else I can find out.
Investigate the table. This table? Got it.
Like the workers found a huge pit, then stopped. I'll probably be out of comms range down there. Track me if you can, and I'll check in when I get a signal. I'm heading down.
Sure. Just don't make me come down there after you.
Brad, please. We got this. Let's go. Oh boy. It's a Talon. Woo. All right, you creepy little shit. Where am I supposed to go from here? Oh, don't play no creepy clown-like music. I don't think that guy is in this game. Crates down here. Another one. Asshole. Screw you. Ow. Mind? Asshole. Anyway. Right? Freaking scary ass cave full of these crazy owl-like creatures. Find excavation research. Hey. So I got everything here, right? Okay, is there something here I'm supposed to find? Nope, we just keep going. Just keep going!
Nobody wants to do science with me. I guess I'll just have to grab a sample for myself.
I guess so. Mining log. Oh wait, there's a crate down there. That's it? Nothing else? We good to go? Dude, can you walk through that fucking door? Yeah. A hell of a cave. Batman would be jealous, I'm just saying. Elevator go up. Oh boy. Somebody's in there. Isn't this just a fun how do you do? Ah, hell, not you assholes again. One of y'all's bad enough. Damn it! Fuck you! Sucker! Thank you! Fuck this place. We out this piece. Okay. Kablooey! Anyone for some fried talons? Almost trapped in here because of a damn cave in. Oh, okay.
Where the hell am I?
I wish the hell I know. Up the elevator shaft, sure. I'm hearing some squealing. I don't like this. No, it didn't come from that rat. I'm hearing talons. Hell yeah.
Of ours is watching from inside of Gotham's walls. They lurk in every shadow, and they rule you, one and all.
You knew we'd find the court. You were just waiting for us to stick our necks out. Something called Dionysium, and it smells like Lazarus pit water to me.
A foul substitute for the true miracle, a contaminated extract. For centuries, the court has been looking for a fountain of youth. Instead, they found the makings of undying monsters.
So they're using Dionysium to make talons, then. Some green goo in exchange for mindless talon ninjas.
Even in their current debased state, the League would never descend to such banality. And the court's greed and corruption prevent them from ever mastering the secrets of the master states.
You turned a chemical reaction into some kind of bullshit holy ritual.
Those are some harsh words. That ceremony resurrected you, Jason.
I knew it was you, Talia. That pit scrambled my mind, but I'm still a damn good detective.
I suppose gratitude was too much to expect in exchange for another stab at life.
After all the shit you've done to me, I don't owe you anything.
With Bruce gone, the court's operation grows. The League of shadows will raise Gotham to the ground unless you silence the court.
Cut the talking and Riddle's bullshit. You want us to get rid of the voice so the League will leave Gotham alone. What's in it for you, though?
I'll do what I can to distract the League. And your path to the Court of Owls will be clear.
Alright, well, this just got really, really interesting.
Now I know how Montoya feels.
Do you, though? Do you really? Alright, let's go back to Belfry.
Did the city records turn up anything?
They didn't. According to the city permits, there's been no mining in Gotham City since the cauldron was completed.
Judging from what we found last night, they've been digging down there for centuries.
Hey, my modern suits made the cutscene. Nice.
Give this a listen, Alfred. Babs managed to repair some of the court voice recordings.
Dionysium brought the Talons back to life.
Sort of. Dionysium's basically weak as Hal Lazarus pit water. Brings back motor functions. But free will's as good as gone.
So what is a Talon exactly? Some kind of feral zombie assassin?
We've all seen weirder shit. Maybe.
Feral zombie. Sounds like Jason, all right.
Got something to say?
I recognize a voice.
Asshole.
The older woman is Constance Cobblepot, I'm fairly certain.
And the others?
More difficult to say. Maybe if I heard them in person.
In person? Tim, put the waveforms on the screen. It's hard to find a match with all the damage and voice modulation. Maybe the matching system would have better luck if
we match what we have against the live voices.
Fun, but how do we find these jackasses?
Two words. Orchard Hotel. The Masquerade. The event of the season. This year's dedicated to Master Bruce.
Gotham's rich, dress up, pretend they're humanitarians. I've been a few times.
So it's Dirtbag Central.
With so many of Gotham's elite together. Security of the Masquerade will be tight. Finding out their plans first would give you an important advantage.
I'll tweak our masks to record telescopic audio.
If we can get a good vantage point, we may be able to put some faces to these mystery voices.
Sounds like our kind of party.
There's new information on the board. Leveraged a mutual acquaintance. The head of security for the Orchard Hotel, Mr. Hendricks, has agreed to a meeting. The details are going to the evidence board.
Stone Cold Criminals. The regulators claim the cauldron as their territory. Use compass or AR to locate premeditated crimes in the area. Okay. Oh, so we're just ready to head out? No other cutscenes or anything?
I've always heard the Orchard Hotel is haunted.
That's true at least one night a year. Bunch of rich ghouls and masks.
Alright guys, I think I'm gonna go ahead and call it a video here. We'll pick up right from where we leave off here. Because I want to see if we unlocked any more suit upgrades and whatnot. So with all that being said, don't forget to like, comment, of course, subscribe, ding the bell if you're digging what I'm doing over here. If you guys are having fun with me on during the Gotham Knights journey, if you will. And yeah, till next one, y'all have a blessed one. Later.